Destination Uri, the morning programme. I'm Rowan Hand. This is Rod O'Hare from the fire service in Uri. You're very welcome, Rod.
Thanks very much for having me, Rod.
It's important because we're at a time of year of candles. We're at the time of year, see the two C's, candles and carelessness, I suppose.
Well, as I said, hand in hand, they're a dangerous combination.
Yeah, absolutely. You know? So what's the advice at the moment from the fire service in relation to the festive season?
Well, you know, to be honest, it doesn't vary very much, Rowan, from our general message on safety, but it's heightened, if you like. You know, particularly at this time of the year, people will be pulling out the decorations, putting up the Christmas trees, and inadvertently increasing the fire loading in their home. Mm-hmm. So all we would ask them to do is have some consideration as to where they're going to locate the tree, make sure the lights are tested, and that they're safe to go on the tree. And for all the budding and amateur electricians out there, think twice before they start joining up cables and overloading sockets.
Yeah. You know, people don't actually, they don't think much about that sort of thing, that you can overload a socket. They don't think that way.
In fairness, there's absolutely no malice in it. You know, when people have six sets of lights and only one plug, they expect to get the six sets of lights to light. What we would suggest is that they would purchase a trailing lead, which is individually fused. If you plug that into your socket in the wall and then plug your individual plugs into that, then it's
all safe.
It's safe enough, it's at least you have a fail-safe built into that system.
Of course.
You know?
Last week was important for you in road safety.
Make
a difference there.
Last week was National Road Safety Week, and we're trying to encourage all the people who share the roads with us as either pedestrians or drivers to help us take our numbers down to zero, to share the road to zero, as we like to call it. We had a few cross-border initiatives there. We were at Dundalk with Dundalk Fire Service, and the Guards and the PSNI were involved. And we gave a bit of a talk on safety on the roads, showed a few hard-hitting videos, and we did an extrication demonstration during which one of the students was a casualty.
Yeah, and so then removing them from a vehicle.
Removing them from a vehicle and all that that entails. And then they give an account of their experience. Mm. And to be quite honest, I think a lot of people were quite shocked by what they heard. It's bad enough having an accident, but to actually go through the physicality of being removed by people who are trying to help you is a trauma in itself.
Yeah, but what people see you going up ladders, but what they don't realise is you do, and that's important, and you do that. But as well, you are the first responders to a road traffic accident very often.
In fairness, if someone's trapped, they will send for us.
You've got to get them out. Yeah. And I remember years ago giving you one of my cars, a long, long time ago, an old car of mine. I gave it to you so that it would do the trick of
You
do that.
It would have went to very good use, because I would assure you before it left the fire station yard, there wasn't much of it left.
So the other thing is electric blankets in the home, for goodness sake.
Yes, and you know, Uri and Mourne District Council, in conjunction with the Home Accident Prevention Group, have quite a programme that rolls out through the year. So I'd ask people to pay attention to the council's website and look to the papers. Two or three times a year they'll have an event in the different areas, Cross McGlen, Newry, Warren Point, Kilkeel, and they offer an opportunity there for people to bring in their electric blankets, have them checked by an electrician and a professional in the field, and if the blanket's defective, he will inform them and give them a voucher towards a new one. You know, and if it's fine, then it's got a clean bill of health. You know, the unfortunate thing with blankets is, like everything else, when we take them off the bed, we fold them. And circuitry isn't very fond of being folded.
No.
So over term of time, you know, that does have an effect on the cabling.
It's all important. And just good watching cuts the head of bad luck.
Look, that's the God's honest truth. Vigilance.
Yeah.
You know, vigilance is the guardian angel in all this. Yeah. And a bit of common sense. And we don't doubt that people have plenty of common sense out there. It's just sometimes, with the best of intentions, it'll do for now, and we'll sort it later. And really, in our busy lives today, we would suggest sort it at the time, then you know it's done.
Rod, you are our guardian angel.
Thank you very much, Rod.
Take care.
Appreciate seeing you. Thank you very much.
Rod O'Hare.